A Hall of Fame jockey is on trial for assaulting his former girlfriend. Today, the friends of both the accuser and Albarado took the stand, offering very different versions of what happened before Kentucky Oaks 2012. WLKY's Steve Tellier is live at the Hall of Justice, where the trial is likely to wrap up sometime tomorrow. Steve?
Now, Vicki, earlier today, both sides of this case called their final witnesses to the stand, and tomorrow, a jury will likely begin deliberating whether to convict Robby Albarado of fourth-degree assault.
Remember, I closed my eyes, and the next thing I know, he was on top of me, and at no point did he get up.
That was Carolina Martinez, Robby Albarado's ex-girlfriend, testifying on Tuesday. She accuses the jockey of assaulting her when he was drunk, after she confronted him with allegations that he was cheating on her. The prosecution claims Albarado violently threw her into a closet. The defense contends the couple fell into that closet, and Martinez was injured by other objects that fell onto her. Whatever happened, Martinez called Alvarado's friends moments later.
At that point, I asked her what happened. The first word she said to me was, "I just caught Robby cheating."
Matthew O'Keefe testified that Martinez never mentioned any violence during that phone call and instead focused on the couple's breakup. He says that Martinez told him she grabbed Alvarado's phone and started calling recent numbers.
And I got a girl on the phone. And she said, and using some profanity, she said, "I made a couple comments about why is she with my boyfriend or what is she doing with my boyfriend."
O'Keefe says that is when the fight got physical.
She said, "Robby forced his way into the bathroom." I said, "What did he do?" She said, "He actually grabbed my arm with one hand and ripped the phone out of my hand with his other hand."
After Albarado's friend left the stand, Martinez's friend took his place, telling the jury that Martinez texted her pictures of her injuries the day after the incident.
Bruises up and down her back and shoulders that were purple and blue.
Jana Flowers says she urged Martinez to report what happened.
My advice to her was to go to the police and to tell her family what had happened.
Why?
Because it's a crime.
The detective who worked this case also took the stand earlier today. During his testimony, he told the jury that Martinez was in quite a bit of pain just after this incident when he first interviewed her, and that she was actually in a sling at the time. But during his cross-examination, Albarado's defense attorney pointed out that Martinez never told that detective that she had moved out of Albarado's home before that incident, that she showed up the day of that incident unannounced at that home, and that a shelf had fallen on her in that closet during this incident. Closing arguments are set to begin right here tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Live at the Hall of Justice, I'm Steve Tellier, WLKY News.